This video is sponsored by Policy Genius. Since the early 90s, lithium-ion batteries have been the golden child in battery technology, powering everything from computers and phones to EVs and even large-scale storage. But as demand for batteries increases, so do the questions about the supply of raw materials, battery performance levels, and affordability. What if there was a battery that could take everything we love about lithium-ion batteries and multiply it? Three times the energy density, but at a fraction of the price. That's what the lithium sulfur battery promises. For decades, this promising battery technology has remained just out of reach. The very chemistry that makes it so incredible also makes it virtually unusable. At least, it used to be. But thanks to a completely accidental discovery, this incredible technology may finally be close at hand. So what's with all the hype surrounding lithium sulfur batteries? Compared to lithium, sulfur is an electrochemically active material that can accept up to 2 electrons per atom at around 2.1 volts compared to lithium ion. Lithium ion cathodes have reached a capacity of around 200 milliamp hours and energy densities around 800 watt hours per kilogram. A lithium sulfur battery, which uses sulfur as the cathode, the negatively charged electrode, and lithium as the anode, the positive end, can reach theoretical energy densities upwards of 2600 watt hours per kilogram. That's over three times the energy density of lithium ion battery. So what does this mean in terms of running your electronics? If you would replace the lithium ion battery in your computer right now with a lithium sulfur battery of the same weight, you could run that computer for over three times as long, or you could achieve the same runtime with a battery that weighs three times less. Imagine what that could do for an electric vehicle. Today's top performing EVs using lithium ion batteries have ranges that top out around 500 miles. Now imagine replacing that lithium ion battery with a lithium sulfur battery. Now a car with a battery that weighs exactly the same could travel 1500 miles on a single charge. And those are just the conservative figures. Some estimates say that lithium sulfur batteries could increase energy densities by up to 500%. That could mean a range of up to 2,500 miles. You could drive from San Diego to Seattle and back on a single charge. Using sulfur as a cathode material could also help reduce the cost of batteries while also helping alleviate some of the impact on various materials. Compared to lithium, sulfur is a far more earth-abundant material, almost as abundant as iron. Today, so many devices rely on lithium, and while it's not exactly a rare material, finding other suitable substitutes will only help us down the road as battery technology becomes more and more necessary, not only for personal electronics and EVs, but for grid storage as well. Sulfur would also eliminate the use of other materials like manganese, nickel, and cobalt, elements that carry both global supply concerns as well as humanitarian issues. But the most convincing reason to utilize sulfur is that it is significantly less expensive than just about every other material currently used for batteries today. Cobalt, for instance, is considered a rare metal, typically priced around $75,000 per metric ton. But since the 2020 pandemic wreaked havoc on the global supply chain, prices have skyrocketed by more than 50% in 2021. Lithium has also seen price inflation due to increasing short-term production, from 7,000 per metric ton to nearly 40,000. But then there's sulfur. And even though it too has seen prices climb the same time period, nearly 47%, the cost is still dirt cheap, coming in around $382 per metric ton. For comparison, for the price of 1 ton of cobalt, you could buy nearly 200 tons of sulfur. But as we mentioned earlier, while lithium sulfur batteries hold so much promise, there's a reason why we haven't seen them in production. But thanks to a groundbreaking, accidental scientific discovery, that might all change. As great as future EVs will be, it's important to remember that EVs are already super awesome today. I've had my Tesla Model 3 for over 2 years now, and I still remember stressing out about finding insurance for it. My previous company wanted to charge me $400 a month to insure my Tesla. After weeks of shopping around, I finally found a good deal. That's where our sponsor this week, Policy Genius, comes in. I no longer struggle with this. In fact, when I bought my new home last year, the first place I went was Policy Genius. Policy Genius is your one-stop shop to find and buy the insurance you need. And getting started is easy. First, head to policygenius.com/tubadavinci, answer a few questions about your situation, and get the best bundle deal possible. Policy Genius works for you, not the insurance companies. In fact, if they find a better deal for you in the future, they'll switch you over for free. Policy Genius has saved customers an average of $1,250 per year over what they were paying for home and auto insurance. Head over to policygenius.com/tubadavinci to get your free home and auto quotes today and see how much you could save. Huge thanks to Policy Genius and you for supporting the companies that support this show. So the reality of lithium sulfur batteries may finally be close at hand thanks to a complete accident made by researchers at Drexel University's College of Engineering. Dr. Vibha Karla and her team were actually testing different methods of overcoming some of the drawbacks often associated with lithium sulfur batteries. As we mentioned earlier, the reaction between the positively charged lithium ions in the sulfur cathode comes with all those amazing benefits we listed before. But that same reaction has some unfortunate side effects. During the charge-discharge process, sulfur goes through a series of structural changes resulting in a formation of chemical deposits called polysulfides. These deposits form tree-like structures called dendrites that branch up from lithium anode, degrading both the anode and the electrolyte, the medium that carries lithium back and forth between the anode and the cathode, effectively killing the battery after a relatively small number of cycles. While a standard lithium-ion battery remains usable for around 1,000 to 2,000 charge cycles, lithium-sulfur batteries in a laboratory condition max out at a fraction of that amount. Meaning in a practical situation, lithium-sulfur batteries would be dead only after a year or two of use. One strategy often used to counter this shuttling effect has been to use ether electrolytes that can dissolve the polysulfides. But these types of electrolytes come with their own baggage, namely that they can be expensive, making them less practical for large-scale applications. They can also be incredibly volatile and unstable. Not to mention, the amount needed to actually solve the shuttling problem could hamper the energy density of the battery, which sort of defeats the entire purpose. Dr. Karla's solution was to find a way to make the batteries function with a more industrial-friendly carbonate electrolyte, the kind used in most lithium-ion batteries. The experiment essentially involved attempting to constrain the sulfur in a carbon nanofiber, effectively trapping the polysulfide so that they wouldn't react with the electrolyte at all. But the experiment failed, or at least it didn't do what Dr. Karla thought it would. But what her and her team discovered was something completely unexpected. When mixed with the carbon nanofiber, the sulfide stabilized into an incredibly rare form called monoclinic gamma sulfur, a form of sulfur that has a rectangular prism form made of 8 sulfur atoms packed together. The thing is, this type of sulfur doesn't typically stay stable at room temperature. In fact, it's usually only created in labs at extremely high temperatures and only appears in nature in extreme environments like oil wells. According to Raoul Pai, a doctoral student in the Department of Chemical and Biological Engineering and co-author of the research, in the last century, there have only been a handful of studies that produced monoclinic gamma sulfur and has only been made stable for about 20 or 30 minutes at most. But here, in this laboratory setting, the team was able to create it completely by accident. So what's so significant about this discovery? It turns out that this particular crystallized form of sulfur doesn't react with the carbonate electrolyte the way other forms of sulfur would, effectively eliminating the polysulfide and shuttling effect along with them. What does this mean for battery performance? When the team put the carbon nanofibers into a lithium sulfur battery with a carbon electrolyte, they were able to cycle it for a total of 4,000 times without losing performance, the equivalent of 10 years of use. Not only that, but the battery they tested had 3 times the capacity of today's lithium-ion batteries. So that's it, right? Problem solved? Let's go ahead and swap out all lithium-ion batteries for lithium sulfur? Well, not quite. See, as with most accidental discoveries, the team now has to figure out why the experiment turned out the way it did. How did this phase of sulfur appear? Can they replicate it? And can they ensure that it would stay that way? So suffice it to say, further research is still needed before we can start seeing these batteries for sale. But the research doesn't stop there. The team is using this discovery to further research into other lithium-free battery technologies like sodium sulfur batteries. So while this accidental discovery hasn't fully made lithium sulfur batteries a reality just yet, they have brought us significantly closer than anything before it. So like with most batteries we talk about on this channel, this is one of those where it's not quite ready for prime time. But as you can imagine, the ramifications of a battery like this is really important. Every electric vehicle manufacturer is struggling with supplies. Battery material supply chains are just difficult, and it's really what keeps companies from making more EVs. So a breakthrough battery like this could be hugely significant, not to mention the better performance and longer life, but just by being diversified and having more various elements come into the battery supply chain, that would just mean all the difference for larger scale battery storage and electric vehicle proliferation. All right, so if you want to see more videos about breakthrough battery technologies, check out this playlist over here. I'm Ricky with Tuba DaVinci. Thank you guys so much for watching. We'll catch you guys next week.